Any tips for going through vet school? Thinking about making that my career path and want to be as knowledgeable about the process as possible. So we actually got a lot of YouTube community comments on this as well. A lot of people who want to make this their career and help animals and want as much advice as possible. So Dr. Gray, I'm sure you have plenty of great stories about making it through vet school.
Well, I do, but they're quite old. And so I thought to be the most helpful to this person, I wanted to reach out to some people who maybe were more frequent, had done it just recently. So I contacted the former SmartPak vet student class rep. Say that three times fast.
Yeah.
she's a 2020 graduate of my alma mater, which is the University of Illinois College of Veterinary Medicine. Her name now is Dr. Cheyenne Sams, and she's at the Piedmont Equine in the Plains, Virginia. So we brought her on as a special guest today so that she can say more recently what some tips might be. Cheyenne, Dr. Sams.
Very exciting. Congratulations, by the way, Dr. Sams.
Oh, thank you. It's a lot of work. And I'm here with Dr. Meredith Frey, who is a 2020 graduate of Colorado State Veterinary School.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
So what tips do you guys have for getting through vet school? I mean, you just recently did it, so I'm sure you guys know all the ins and outs of how to survive.
Yep.
Yeah, it's hard. I think the first thing to know is that it's hard, and it's not just going to be a walk in the park. A lot of people from school, like from my school, said that they had an easy time in college and that vet school was a lot tougher. It's not a walk in the park, but it's very rewarding. I think when you get to fourth year and you get on clinics and you can see that you have learned so much and grown so much, I think it's all worth it in the end.
Yeah, some of those moments I remember specifically in fourth year where I surprised myself. I was like, oh, I knew that. Like I'm starting to have that kind of perception of being a doctor, you know, in the fourth year where we're almost close to it. And it really was kind of some of those years, the early years where you're just stuck in the books and you're like, I wanted to be a veterinarian. I wanted to work on animals. And all I'm doing is studying in a classroom surrounded by four walls in a classroom, like the same classroom with no windows, what felt like 12 hours a day.
And the same people. It felt like high school again, because it was a fairly small class size and it was the same people every day. And we sat, I don't know about you guys, we sat in the same seats every single day.
Oh,
pretty much,
God.
Yeah.
We had our seats and no one messed up the seating, like the seating arrangement.
Oh,
then
gosh,
everyone
that was
had
hectic.
had to get a new seat.
And we had lockers. I mean, it was high school all over again. Yeah.
2.0.
Yep.
Yeah. So what are some study tips? Like, what were your study? How did you make yourself study when you wanted to be done with books and walls and things?
For me, it was, so becoming a veterinarian is a second career for me. So I did the whole undergrad onto a career path in hotel and restaurant management and then decided to come back to vet school. So for me, I knew that just being an older student, I would really need some support of my peers to just kind of dive into topics, especially things that, you know, I forgot about, you know, some physiology things that I didn't remember from my undergrad years and stuff. I really needed some support from some of my peers and who had more so just recently taken some of those courses. So I loved study groups. I got in with a study group super early on and we became just a team. There were five of us from first year and we just became a really solid team all through the 4 years. So I really owe a lot of, you know, my grades and my knowledge to them, and I probably owe them all the coffee in the world just because they helped away late nights trying to get through some of those exam preps. So that's for me.
Yeah, I agree. I think having just a close group of friends, they can get you through anything.
Yeah.
You know, you can go to them with anything and they're gonna help you as best they can. And I think the other thing for me is that you know, when I realized when I was studying or whatever, when I realized I got to the point where I just couldn't focus, I'd take a break. You know, otherwise I'd sit there and do the same thing over and over again and I would never learn it. So I'd just take a break, try to go for a run, eat, do something just to take 30 minutes and then I could go back to doing studying.
Well, that's a really good point is when you think of getting through vet school, you think of the studying and the tests and the hours and occasionally working on, if not real animals, then, you know, pretend animals like suturing when you learn it, you know, But the taking care of yourself is also a huge part of it, or you'll never get through. So it's, you know, what were your guys' what are some tips on eating right and exercising and, you know, staying connected with family and friends? Why are you laughing?
Eating right.
I think during vet school, it was a little easier just because we had a little bit more of, it was the mental game of vet school. So I think that taking care of ourselves during vet school was a little bit easier to accomplish. And we're just laughing about it because now as interns, we're finding that it's not only a mental game, but it's also a physical game. So we're trying to really, we are trying to take care of each other and say, you know, have you eaten today? And but vet school, I think, was a little bit easier. Like friends, you know, it was always easy for us to say, you know, I need a break, let's go grab lunch, or let's go outside into the grass and get some sunshine and eat lunch, kind of a thing. And I think that was a little bit easier of an accomplishment for us during vet school. It's a little different now as interns, I think.
A little harder
just to find some time there to take care of ourselves. But vet school, it was, I have my dog, Cheyenne had her dog and cat, and those were really great, just cuddle moments. You know, I just cuddle and turn all my attention to my dog and kind of self-soothe with my dog.
Yeah. Dogs make everything better.
Everything better.
I ask one more question. Just what were your most favorite and least favorite classes or courses? Like, which are you glad? You're like, phew, it's done, I never want to do that again. Or that's, I love that, that's what I want to be when I'm, this internship year is done, I'm going to focus on that.
Yes, so it's twofold. We had, at Colorado State, they have tried to really encourage communication, like client communication, and they built an entire course around communicating with clients, and even go as far as like getting actors to come in and play the very upset, very irate client that, you know, you're mimicking just a situation where you can't appease anyone with anything you say or anything you do. So they really try to push us in that way to learn and build from that. And I remember sitting through those classes and those courses and just hyping myself up, like anxiety wise, this is going to be a terrible situation. But now that I think about it, now that I'm actually a veterinarian, thinking about some of those key concepts that they were really trying to drill into us were some of the best things that I had. So it's not necessarily all about the animals, you know, there's a person attached to that animal. And that is really one of those things that reminding ourselves, like, we're getting into this profession because we love animals, but there are always humans that we have to deal with as well. And client communications was one of my least, but looking back on it, one of my best courses.
Cool.
Appreciated.
Love that.
All right. We gave you some time to think, Cheyenne.
I know. Yeah. I think so. My least favorite was actually very easy to come up with. And that was, it was renal physiology.
Oh, gosh.
We had a tough professor. It's just a hard class. And I think I kind of went in with the attitude like, oh, if I don't like it, I just don't have to study as much for it because I'm not going to need it as much. So now looking back, that was a huge mistake on my part, because now anything renal, I'm like, I don't remember. I need to go look at my notes.
Mm. And for the listeners, renal means?
Kidneys. Yeah.
Look at you guys.
And I think my favorite was actually, I think, anesthesiology, any course taught by the anesthesiologist at school. Yeah, cool. And not necessarily because, like, anesthesia scares me. I think it's very frightening. But the anesthesiologists just love their job so much. And they are fantastic lecturers. And they are so invested in trying to get us to learn and love it as much as they do. It just kind of rubbed off on me. It was just, I just really enjoyed that class, those classes.
That's cool. Well, this brought back so many memories. So I could talk to you guys all day, but I know we're on a schedule.
That was great. Thank you guys so much. And I'm sure that helped a lot of viewers at home who are thinking about going into vet school, what they can kind of prepare for and get themselves mentally prepped for the challenge ahead. But we need lots of great vets out there. So hopefully you inspired a lot of people to continue that path. So thank you so much for coming on and doing that.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it's been rewarding so far.
Absolutely.
Okay. We'll try to get some sleep, guys.
Thank you.